about 100 gangs on Toronto streets. That's the number that the head of Toronto Police Gun and Gang Task Force offered up in a very frank discussion with us today. We wanted to talk about the amount of gun violence on Toronto streets right now and the different approach police are taking to try and combat the problem. This is the point when it's too late, when the shots have already been fired and the criminals have killed others before they could be stopped.
What does it take to be able to get those guns off the street?
Well, we need information about who has the firearms. And, our investigators start with some information. It might be some observations that they've made personally. It may be some occurrences of incidents being reported.
Police say 56 firearms have been seized since July the 1st. How significant that is tough to tell based on similar numbers in 2018.
This year, we're down just slightly, but it's because of those two major seizures last year. So we're on par. The girls and guys that are working are out there arresting, similar numbers of people in possession of firearms.
The highlight for police so far this year has been Project Kraken. Nearly 600 charges against 73 people after a major investigation into a street gang with ties to something much bigger.
Is it that varied that it can go from something that's maybe three people to organized crime and something that is much more expensive than that?
Well, absolutely. Project Kraken, which wrapped up in the end of June, looked at a gang that we had, a group of people, we'll call it, that we investigated and we realized it was a criminal organization.
How do you define a gang?
We work with our intelligence unit. They kind of direct us saying this gang is involved in violence. This gang is identifying different criminal acts that they're benefiting from, and then we'll investigate it.
Toronto police are now 1 week into Project Community Space, an attempt to go beyond what they call suppression tactics and arrests into connecting to more people in vulnerable neighborhoods.
We can put the people in jail, but if there's a vacuum behind them, we're going to deal with it again.
What do you expect by the end of this 11 weeks?
I really don't know. We've got 11 weeks and we're going to do everything we can to have the biggest impact as possible, and we'll take the chief's lead after that.
As part of that emphasis on education, prevention, and awareness, Toronto Police have actually set up 18 different town halls in different neighborhoods before the end of the year. They also hope that the extra neighborhood officers that are out there in those areas will also act as a resource for people to turn to, in addition to being a deterrent for those criminals.